My name is Robert Newberry. I am an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry in the College of Natural Sciences, and I am also an out gay man. I am a chemical biologist, and I study how the properties and behaviors of molecules result in the phenomena of life. And we focus specifically on molecules in the brain that contribute to neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. So I think everybody's identity intersects with their work differently. For me personally, I find that I'm a more successful scientist because I'm out. The emotional toll it takes to, you know, conceal or change yourself to fit other people's perception reduces your capacity to engage in the other things you want to be doing in the world. Feeling like I had that freedom to worry not about my identity, but rather about the kinds of problems that I see in the world and the kinds of impacts that I want to have has given me more power and ability to really make progress on those problems. What people assume is true need not actually be true. We have perceptions or preconceived notions about the way the world is or about the way a person is, and in many cases those perceptions or assumptions are wrong. I came to appreciate that we can and should challenge those notions, and I think that's one of the things that makes me a better scientist, that we have agency to shape the world and make it more of what we want to see it be. I started openly telling people that I was gay early in graduate school. I was in a better mood. I was a more excited, more enthusiastic, energetic person. There is no one way to be queer in STEM. I certainly found value in being out as a scientist, but you know, I recognize that other people are in very different positions, and if it is a better fit for somebody else to not be out, that is okay too. There is no right or wrong time to come out. Part of being a productive scientist is bringing a new and distinct perspective to problems, and so I think people should feel like wherever they are in, you know, either appreciating their identity or integrating their identity into their work, those are all right answers. I think there's great science to come from folks in all of these different positions, regardless of how people view the intersection of their identity and their science.